Hi, I'm Pat Higby. This is Ryan Anderson, and we're going to assemble a very simple wind tunnel. Our first step is to put the base onto our fan. We're using a 20-inch industrial floor fan. However, a simple box fan would work just as well. So we're going to get the base on, and we're just going to screw that together. And that's it. Okay, now that we've got the bases on both of our fans, we're going to add the Velcro strips that are going to keep our wind tunnel fabric, our vinyl, in place. I like to put the soft part of the Velcro on the fan because you'll be using these fans for other things as well, and you don't want the rough part to catch on clothes and so forth. You'll need about a yard of Velcro. If you get our kit, it'll come with that included. I'm cutting anywhere from 1.5 to 2 inch strip off from there. And now I prefer to put it in so that it overlaps onto the top. So I slip it in and then I pull it up through the gap in the fan, and then we overlap it on the top. And there, we're ready to go. We'll do that in 5 other spots with you. We like to secure it fairly well across the top part of the fan. So we'll put one here between these 2 spots. The one that we've got there, 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 and there. And then for a little extra security, I like to add the Velcro onto the base as well. So we'll go ahead and do that now. This is the vinyl we're going to use for our wind tunnel. It's available at fabric stores like Joann's or at Hobby Lobby. It comes on a very big roll. It's 54 inches wide. You just need 1 yard of it. Off from the backing, and it is going to drape over the fans. Now you'll notice it's a little bit saggy in the middle. Well, we're going to solve that problem by taping on some pieces of welding rod. These are 36 inches wide, 1/8 inch aluminum rod. We got them at a welding supplier. And then we're going to put 5 of those. We're going to put 1 at the top and then 2 on each side of that. At the base, right here at the very bottom, we're going to use a 3/16 inch steel rod. I like to use a little bit bigger, heavier rod on the bottom because this is where you're going to be lifting up and opening your wind tunnel, and so you want to have it nice and sturdy. So we're going to go ahead and take those on. Now, our location, let's see. Ryan, let's make sure that we're equally distributed. I'm about 1 or 2 inches above the tabletop. Are we about equal?
Closer to 1 inch.
Okay, this way a little bit?
Yes.
Okay, there we are. All right. So we're going to take a magic marker, and we're just going to mark where we're going to put this. I'm going to put 1 at the top. Actually, we can use these ribs as our guide. 1, 2, 3. And you want to mark out at the rib the 4th and the 5th. And then rather than to mark on the other side, if we just fold this up and over, we can duplicate it from the first one, and that way you'll know that we're going to be equal. All right, so we're just going to take these down. Over onto the line just a little bit. There we go. This doesn't have to be a perfect job, and it's a great one where you can get your kids to help you with. I don't usually overlap it, so we'll just trim that off at the end. Mm-hmm. So we're going to do that for the 5 in the center, And then on the end, we're going to take our 3/16-inch rod, and I'm actually going to let the tape overlap that. You could, if you wanted to, roll it up a little bit. I don't usually do that. I'm going to put it on. So it's fairly close to the end. And then I'm just going to flip it up and tape the other side. This just gives us a nice little handle that we can use to lift the vinyl out of the way for our wind tunnel. Okay, now that we've got our rods taped on, we're ready to add the Velcro to the vinyl. And we're going to, we've already placed a Velcro piece here, and we're going to just take the backing off from it and just allow it to fit right on there. Ryan's doing his. But then it's a little harder to get underneath. So we're just actually going to mark across here to show where the Velcro is going to go. And when we attach that Velcro from underneath, it's going to bridge across there. This allows us to have a little bit of flexibility, because the next time we put this wind tunnel together, it may not be in exactly the same orientation, but we've got a little bit of play in the area there. So we'll just put this Velcro on underneath, right under there. Two of our Velcro strips in place, but I wanted to show you how we put those on. We've already shown you that we just took the backing off from this side one, and we just flip it up and over. Here's my mark. And that's where I have to have my sticky, loopy side. And it's just going to go right directly over that mark and kind of centered on there. Just like that. And then when you're finished, those should line up fairly well to give you a nice, secure, safe wind tunnel. The wind tunnel is really important for safety reasons. Those little wind turbines don't spin all that fast, but they're usually have kids looking at them at eye level. Any piece that flies off, you don't want to get into anyone's eyes. And so you don't need a lot of strength, but you need something to stop that piece. So this is what's going to protect those kids' eyes. Okay, so here's our completed wind tunnel. We've got a couple of turbines in there that we're going to test. Ryan, you want to turn it on?
Of course.